This chart shows some common functions, common basic functions, and their derivatives. Talked about these in previous videos. The polynomial is a monomial because there's just one term, x to the n. The derivative, you multiply by the exponent and then decrease the exponent by 1. Now, the function is e to the x, that's real simple. The derivative is e to the x. Now, ln x, this has an interesting derivative. It's equal to 1 over x, or x to the negative 1. And sine and cosine have an interesting relationship. The derivative of sine is cosine, and the derivative of cosine is negative sine. Now, these basic functions can be combined together to make more complicated functions, and on the next couple pages I'm going to show a few basic rules for dealing with compound functions. So what do we do when we combine functions? First I'm going to show some examples on this page, and the next page I'll show it in more general terms. Now, one thing we can do with two functions are add or subtract them, and actually I've in some examples I've done before, I've done this. It's quite easy to find the derivative of functions that are subtracted. You just find the derivative of each of the functions individually and either add or subtract depending on what's done in the function. So x cubed becomes 3x squared, x squared becomes 2x, and you subtract. Now, another thing that can be done with function, I think I've done this too in examples, is to multiply the function by a constant. And it's quite simple what to do with the derivative. You just take the derivative of the function and multiply it by the same constant. Now, this next one is a little more subtle. Here, we're not multiplying the function by a constant, but we're multiplying the variable by a constant. And the derivative of this will be, we just multiply, we take the derivative of the function, and e to the sum power, the derivative is e to that same power. This function here remains the same. And then we multiply by the constant that's multiplied by the variable. Now the next one is getting a bit more complicated. We're taking a function of a function. Here we have cosine, not of x, but cosine of x cubed. And the way we deal with that is you first take the derivative of the function inside, which would be 3x squared, and then you take the derivative of the whole function with this function remaining inside the derivative. It will look like this. The derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. The derivative of cosine is minus sine. That's why the minus is in front here. And the derivative of cosine becomes sine. And it's the same function inside the sine that was inside the cosine. So this is called the chain rule. Now the next way of combining functions that we can deal with is if you multiply two functions. Here's an example, x to the fifth times sine x. Now when two functions are multiplied together, we take the derivative of one of the functions and multiply it by the other function, and then take the derivative of the other function and multiply it by the first function and add those two together. So it'll look like this. This is called the product rule. Product is the result of multiplying two things together. So x to the fifth becomes 5x squared, that's the derivative of x to the fifth, and we multiply it by the function, and then we take the derivative of sine, which is cosine, and multiply it by the other function and add the two together. So notice this is a derivative and this is the original function, and this is the derivative and this is the original function, and you add them together. And the final thing we do with combining functions is we divide two functions. Take one function and divide it by another. Now, this has a similar rule as when you multiply two functions, but as you might expect, when we take the derivative of the function on the bottom, instead of adding, we subtract. And there's another twist that goes with this, but let's first look at the first part of this. This is called the quotient rule. And I take the derivative of the first function, derivative of ln x is 1 over x, and multiply it by the other function, and then subtract the derivative of the function on the bottom times the first function. And like I said, there is a twist to this. Notice I've got a line under all this, because after we do this part, we divide the whole thing by the bottom function squared. Okay, so those are rules we use when we have combination functions. And on the next page, I have this written out in general terms, which might look a bit like hieroglyphics. I think it makes more sense to see examples like this, but just so you can have a general terms, I'm going to show this to you. So we have these functions u of x and v of x and constants c, k, and n. And we can take two functions and multiply them by constants and add them together. And it's just the derivative of the first function times whatever constant it was multiplied by, and the derivative of the second function multiplied by whatever function it was multiplied by. And this property is called linearity. When you add two functions, possibly multiplied by different constants, you just take the derivatives multiplied by the same constants and add them together. Now, if you have a function and it's the variable that's multiplied by a constant, you just take the derivative of the function and you multiply the result by the constant that the variable is multiplied by. Notice in the brackets we still have the variable multiplied by that constant, so this constant appears in both places, still multiplied by the variable and multiplied by the derivative. Now this next one is the chain rule. We have a function, and inside the function we have another function. Well, to do that, we take the derivative of the function inside and we multiply it by the function on the outside, and the function on the outside still has that same function on the inside. So the derivative of the function on the inside is, has a variable. It's the derivative of the variable. Function on the outside is the derivative of the other function. This is called the chain rule. Now the product rule, we have two functions multiplied together. We take the derivative of each and multiply by the function of the other and add them together. This is the first, the derivative of the first function times the second function, plus the derivative of the second function multiplied by the first function. That's the product rule. And the quotient rule looks very much like this, except we subtract the product where we have taken the derivative of the function on the bottom. And then we finally have to divide by the bottom function squared. So these are the ways of dealing with more complicated functions that have the basic functions combined together in various ways.